soon, Cadence Next.
Hello and welcome to Retro Game Connect. I'm Dan Mastriani.
I'm Ian Butterfield.
And today, we're going to drive. We're hitting up Beetle Adventure Racing for Nintendo 64. This one, I feel, is kind of forgotten. I think it was pretty popular at the time, but it seems to have just dropped off the map, which I think is a shame.
Well, I mean, I don't remember it, but I never had it in 64. So.
Now, you were pretty young at the time. I mean, I feel like it got a decent amount of press. You know, it got like a cover issue of Nintendo Power, things like that. And nowadays, people don't really remember it. But it's a pretty interesting game. It was developed by Paradigm Entertainment, which unfortunately no longer exists. But they originally started out in like 3D graphics technology, flight simulators, kind of really realistic technical things.
Mm.
But they hooked up with Nintendo around the development of the N64. They were actually picked to work directly with the development team at Silicon Graphics. You know, Silicon Graphics designed the hardware of the Nintendo 64. That's why it was so advanced, because it was designed by the same people who were making 3D graphics workstations at the time. And they got to build like a technical base for their games early on. So their first game actually was Pilot Wing 64. And they got a lot of mentorship from Nintendo. Nintendo helped them out in making the game. And Chris, Pilot Wing 64 was a launch game for the system. Sequel to Pilot Wings on the Super Nintendo. Pretty well remembered. So this is a development team with some pedigree. And EA, I guess, decided to contract them. You know, EA came up with the concept for the game. They were looking at the Nintendo 64 and thinking about, what is the Nintendo 64 good at? Nintendo 64 is streaming from cartridge, so it's pretty fast.
Mm.
It doesn't have as much of a limit for texture size as PlayStation 1 did, so you don't get the old crazy warp textures and such like that. So they could build big levels. So they're like, okay, let's build a game with just like huge levels. Lots of secrets and shortcuts.
I did track before we started shooting, and I was like, oh wow, I'm still on lap one. Okay.
They're pretty big. They're less of secrets. I guess they were actually inspired by platformers and adding lots of secrets and a lot of verticality and jumps and all kinds of stuff like that. So they were already committed to making, let's make a fun racing game, because their market research has said, like, you know, people on N64 like arcade style racers. So they'd already come up with that concept, and later on, they were meetings like, you know, what kind of game would be fun to put in here? It's like, you know what? It'd be really fun to put a VW Beetle in there. Like, just a year before the game had come out, VW would come out with a new Beetle, right? Their new model of Beetle, they brought the Beetle back. Their campaign focused on how fun to drive the car was, less like irreverent, humorous ads. So they got in touch with VW, and VW was like, yes.
Yes, let's market all the things.
Yeah, they actually told them that people had come to them before wanting to do realistic games, and they felt like it didn't really match their brand. They were trying to be fun. They didn't want like some staid, super realistic, let's adjust gear ratios and carefully customize our car in real world physics. They're like, no, we like your approach. We want to make a wacky game, crazy over the top jumps and dinosaurs and aliens, and yes, do it all. Go. So apparently it was just a marriage made in heaven. And it came out with Beetle Adventure Racing. Even though a lot of developers had worked on Need for Speed previously, which was more realistic racer, they just wanted to go fun here. They started off with super realistic physics engine designed by Paradigm, and just kind of, you know, tweaked it until it was more forgiving and easier to play. So honestly, this is a kind of game where I think you really have to play it to understand. You know, a lot of people are probably watching this and like, wait, licensed game made by EA? Oh. Ooh.
But it has the ending pre-installed.
Yes, now DLC hadn't been invented yet. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. That's still for the future.
It's had add-on cartridges. Eventually, you have a tower this tall.
No. That was a Sega thing. Come on now. But you know what? Playing is believing. So I think we should go ahead and start up Beetle Adventure Racing.
Nintendo.
All right. So, yeah, there you go. There's the Volkswagen logo.
V-dubs.
Electronic Arts, old logo. Of EA. Their many old logos, they've
Tell
had several.
Everything.
They've been around for a while.
They really have.
They started out on personal computers, actually.
Really?
Yeah, like the early Maddens and such, they were PC games.
Huh.
And they started getting into consoles when they figured out how to reverse engineer Sega's copy protection. They were like, look what we can do, Sega. So how about you let us license for your system, or we'll just release games anyway. That's why all the EA cards for Sega Genesis have that like yellow tab. I don't know if you've ever seen an EA card. I have at least one. I think we will probably see it in the future. But yeah, they were kind of like, yeah, we're just going to release games anyway. So, oh, that card just kind of exploded.
Oh my. There's
one of the unlockable cards that unfortunately I don't have because I lost my save. Back in the N64 PlayStation 1 era, you never ever wanted to buy third-party memory cards. Couldn't trust them.
I remember having one for my PlayStation that was really good.
Yeah. A lot of them...
PlayStation 2.
Yeah. By PS2, they've gotten better.
Yeah.
In the PS1 era, don't trust them.
Didn't trust anything in the PS2 era. Yeah.
All right, the PS1. So go ahead. We'll take a quick look. You've got championship races. That's how you'd unlock more stuff. We're not going to bother doing the one-player mode right now because it looks largely the same. If you guys want to see what the single race mode looks like, you're going to have to play it yourself.
If you want to see what the single mode looks like, just enhance the top screen of the bottom screen.
Zoom in. Enhance.
Zoom in.
All right, so Coventry Cove or Mount Mayhem?
Let's go Coventry Cove, because I live near a Coventry.
There you go. That sounds good. All right, so we're going to do some screen, see what cards we get to start with. I guess I'll go with the all-rounder. Yeah, neither of us are crazy enough to do automatic, or manual, rather.
I know how to drive a manual, but not on a controller.
There you go.
All right. My car is a manual.
I do not have a rumble pack, so... Continue there. There we go, so we get a little flyby of the stage. You can see it's pretty big. I like that little analog speedometer in the corner. That's fun. Oh! I'm going a little far. Yeah, you can start ahead of me, I know about that. That seems a little unfair to me. Whoa!
It's because I picked a car that's the same color as my controller.
Oh. Yeah, could be. I can't seem to reverse. That's a problem. That's not good for me. You may have an insurmountable lead unless I find a crazy shortcut. It's been a long time since I played this, so my handling is clearly pretty off.
I played this about 20 minutes ago.
Yeah.
For the first time.
Yeah. Cheater. All right, well, while you were playing that, I think I noticed a shortcut you did not take. Bridge it up. It's a little... I mean, we're gonna... screen. Unfortunately, I don't have, like, S-video for this system or anything. So we're a little blurry. That's a bit of a trademark... failing of the N64 because the textures can be a little blurry. Let's cut across the grass one now. I'm going to crash from the barn. Oh, they'd already took the doors off the barn. I didn't get to crash through. That's disappointing. Of course, you have your regular brake and you can the emergency brake to do big turns. So I think I want to tap it instead of just holding it. Otherwise, you just stop. Which is not very helpful. The problem is you're going so fast you can also often miss shortcuts like I just did there. Are you listening to your controller?
Yes.
What is it telling you?
Gotta go fast.
Ah.
It It's a defector controller.
There you go.
It's actually a Sonic fan.
Uh-huh. Blasphemy. Sega and Nintendo were still competitors at this time. What's it saying? Still an N64 controller. You'll never work on the Dreamcast.
You might say it's a pipe dream for it.
Oh, yes. I'm looking at the little map, and I think I haven't completely lost you yet, but well, farther back than I'd like to be. Nice big waterfall like this. Oh, we're already on the second lap. I didn't even notice. I see you found a shortcut. Oh, I'm within sight of you. I'm not sure which one of us picked a car with a higher top speed.
I did.
That could be trouble for me.
But it also means it has less handling.
That is true.
Hence why I'm crashing into everything.
Yeah, that could be a problem.
Like a certain Bandicoot did.
Haha. Oh, Crash Bandicoot. Yeah, I don't think that barn is really useful without the Nitro power-ups.
No.
We might have to do a quick single-player race then, because there don't seem to be any power-ups or anything in the multiplayer. I would like to show this off. I hit the wall and I bounced off when I was just about to take the shortcut. I think actually you have to go in earlier to catch that. I will test my theory on the next lap. You know, careful. That quote isn't family friendly.
Not the full quote. First half. Direction. Oh my goodness.
Oh no.
Oh yeah.
Yep, this is actually also not really a good shortcut. It's just to pick up some extra hidden stuff. Oh no. Same thing as messed me up before. I don't know where the reverse is on this. So close. NASCAR games assure me that rubbing is racing. Well, as for NASCAR games, because I don't think I've ever actually played one. Oh, I got all mixed up. That shadow was in my way, and I thought I was heading for a shortcut, and I was just heading for a wall. That's bad. It's a nice jump, though.
Woo!
Get back here, you! So this game actually takes a lot of concentration, so it's proving kind of hard to...
I'm going to win.
God, proving kind of hard to offer intelligent commentary while playing.
Just references.
There we go. That's fine, right? This is the internet. Oh, I bounced off the wall. But I finally made it into the shortcut. But how short is this shortcut?
Not short enough.
Quite possible. That's cool though. There's a waterfall in there. Big jump. I'm not sure if I'm getting ahead of you or not. No, I'm not.
It actually jumped you up further back. What? No. That would be funny.
Yeah. It's a long cut. It was a trap.
It's a trap. Hey, yo, this TIE fighter's here.
Get about it. Way to go. I feel like we should try to start like the Monte Carlo Mario Mafia. Hashtag or something.
Don Akbar.
Yeah, there we go.
Hey, yo, with this Death Star here.
Yay, I'm going to enter my initials. Why not? So I'm about to miss. Do you want to try and quickly do a single-player race to show off the
You can't really do a race quickly.
Yeah. Squid. Interesting. Congratulations. You set a new track record.
Woo!
Yep. Why not?
Squid shall rule them all.
Yes. Let us quit and let us show off battle mode. The Beetle battle. I think it'll bring back some. We can only do two player because I didn't bring the other two controllers because we're only two of us to play. So we got various stages. We got an airport stadium.
Stadium because we played Pokemon Stadium.
Well, that will have been a while ago. So I think we get identical Beetles for this.
Bright pink.
I'll be the black Beetle.
Groovy.
So I guess this kind of is going to resemble battle mode in Mario Kart, I'm thinking.
Oh, all I know is that it said groovy.
That's always fun. I now have rockets. And I can shoot them with the R. I don't know if I actually hit you, though. Oh! That's troubling.
Oh, I blew up.
Yeah. Yeah, you did. Now I'm down here. And I'm trying to find you again. Okay. Oh, we're driving past each other. Huh. So, yeah, it looks like you do have a big crisscrossing arena, just like in the old school Mario Kart game. I thought that was a ramp back up, but apparently it wasn't. There you go, and there are power-ups that I couldn't actually get. All right, I think we're on the way to each other, maybe? No. This has always been one of the problems with battle modes, is when you can't actually find each other. Oh. Oh, didn't want to do that at all.
Oh! Well,
that didn't work out for me. I still can't figure out. I changed the view. I still can't. Oh, wow, is it powered down? It's bad.
No, sir, I didn't like it.
Hmm.
There's a reference for you.
Gritty kitty.
Yippee-ki-yay!
Uh-oh. I've got a Beetle on my six. Okay. I think I got a shield. You don't have any agents? I don't know. Oh, it expired. That's sad. What to do, what to do?
Stop running away!
I'm trying to figure out a way to do a nice, quick... Why are you running away? What? What? Oh, I was actually backing up. How did... Oh, I figured it out. All right, I finally figured out how to reverse. You have to hold the handbrake and the gas. That's a little unintuitive. I was a little slow on the draw there. Oh, there's a near miss. And I whiffed again. All right. We shall joust at each other, I think. I see what you're doing. I have a map. Oh, no! I don't know what that did. You know.
Nope.
I'm confused. Oh, God. Do we have to kill each other like 6 times to win this mode? I feel like we do. I'm not sure how I feel about that. I don't think I like it. Oh, now I have rockets because I... That was nasty. I agree. I did not hit you. Awesome. Oh, good lord. Oh no, I'm out of missiles.
feel like this would be more intense if there were more players.
Yeah. This was, you know, intended for...
like, bazillions.
For four-player mode, so... Also, we both need to be terrible shots, so that's not really helpful.
It's not like we have a reticle.
Yeah.
Doing more damage to ourselves running into these skull boxes.
Quite possibly. Alright. How about you, sir?
No!
Oh, I actually hit you. It's a miracle. Oh no, we have to kill each other. Six times in a row? What? Now I have two and you have none? What is going on? I'm not quite understanding this game mode.
I think I do. I'm gonna test my theory though. Like a good scientist.
Yes. Whoa! I'm not sure what just happened there. Oh.
He's almost
now you have a red, and I don't get it. I just don't get it. You have to get a kill with every weapon, or what is a nitro car that I just toyed with?
I just kind of plowed through you.
Yeah. So what? Oh, jeez. And another skull. Okay, so I'm thinking maybe we shouldn't play this to completion because this is going to take quite a while. Oh, I just suddenly switched to a different view. Did I accidentally hit the button?
Feel like, again, this is a game you need more people for.
Yeah, I really think we should just quit because it's going to take us forever to finish this.
So long and thanks for all the fish, click.
All right. Got a little time. Let's do one quick one-player race so people can see the normal.
Sure.
We'll do full grid. Why not? On easy. We do Mob Mayhem because we haven't seen it yet. Oh, I got to pick Days of Black. That's nice. There you go. Awesome.
Welcome to Mount Mayhem.
Great.
Silly enough game, but not like crazy silly.
Yeah, there's wackier stuff later on. I think there's also a turbo boost you can get.
Nope, you just managed to make your car dematerialize for a second.
I'm not really sure what that did. But we'll attempt to show it off. See, I wish I hadn't lost my save. Because there are much wackier courses later on that, of course, we don't have access to right now. Because they need to be unlocked.
There's an entire road made of rainbows, isn't there?
I believe you're thinking of Mario Kart.
Ah!
2 points! Yep. For two. Oh, there was another shortcut there. I should have gone that way. Oh, well.
Failed.
Yeah, and I'm in last place. But you as you collect points, I believe those go toward unlocking things. So I'm going to go ahead and 2 points. Not get the other 2 points. Okay.
They're sort of like real money in any other EA game.
Yeah. I get this impression that you don't like EA.
Oh, it depends on the game. They're just easy fodder.
They are. But, you know, they have been for a long time.
As Ubisoft has been slowly becoming as well.
Yeah.
With microtransactions and unfinished games.
Yeah. I would say just not even worry about that because it's kind of rough and can get dated anyway. So I got another 2 points, why not? And then moving up.
Moving on up.
Yep. You guys are easy. I'm still on the first lap. These I feel like this went a lot faster when we were playing two-player. I wonder if the tracks have actually been shortened.
Oh, no. No, they are just ridiculously long.
I know, but I mean, I felt like when we were playing the two-player, we smashed through it pretty quick. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Oh, this is much more impressive than the first stage anyways. I mean,
I think it's a larger stage overall.
So I will try to complete this as quickly as possible so we can see what happens. Oh, I missed the waypoint box. I'm slowly moving up, however. Aha! I spotted a secret. Here's a nitro that would help me out. Am I losing you? Oh, that was interesting.
Ugh.
So could I have, like, skipped across there and skipped something, or I don't know.
Coming up on this joik.
I am. Beeping at me. Fun extra feature. I was looking this stuff up. I didn't remember this off the top of my head. But there is a police car. It's one of the unlockable cars. I guess it's a police beetle.
Yeah, I was going to say, like a police beetle or a police interceptor.
Yeah. No, it's still a beetle. But it's,
a police beetle would be interesting to see in real life.
Yeah, it would be. It'd be quite a car.
Yes.
But the police beetle can actually pull over other racers.
Ah!
So I thought that's a fun little feature.
Like road rash.
Yes. Oh, no!
Oh, no.
Oh, I was doing so well. I'm still in third, though. No, you can't get in front of me. Go away.
Not even if you ask nicely.
He wasn't asking nicely. He was
being a joik.
Yeah, gun right in. Rear-ending me. Doesn't he know he's supposed to follow at least 3 car lengths behind?
No, it's 3 seconds behind.
There you go.
Now, because you're supposed to now take the time to look at the side of the road and go, ah, yes, it has been 3 seconds since that vehicle has passed, and gotcha. I have now passed that. We are good.
Good to go.
I never understood that.
Well, I'm pretty sure you took your driver's test more recently than I did.
Well, yes. 2012. That is what... I was like, why don't we just do 3 car lengths? Well, because there are different cars on the road, and what car are you supposed to use? And like, your car, you're in that car, that's the length you have to stop.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know, it seemed logical to me.
You're trying to mix common sense and bureaucracy. I think that's your mistake. Yay, I just got 5 points. This actually doesn't seem to be tracking my points anywhere that I can see. So I guess I won't know how many I got until the end.
11 bajillion.
Wonderful. That's exactly what I wanted. I'm going to go ahead and take this shortcut again.
Got a Brazilian points.
There you go. That's what you get from Terry Gilliam, right?
Yes.
I don't think I was probably supposed to land there, but whatever, it worked out. Oh, no!
Oh.
It didn't work out. Uh-oh, better get Mako. As a bit of data reference. Is Mako even still around? I haven't seen a commercial for
think
in
so.
Quite some time.
The one in Willimantic shut down.
Alright, I think I could have also gone that way, but I never have.
Maybe they were taken over by the squid people.
Darn squid people. You could have voted for a third party. And waste your vote. Wow.
Oh.
Wow.
You did not do well on that part.
Yeah, that's going to be in trouble. I'm supposed to do a crazy jump off.
Have the crossover. Have the crossover between this and Call of Duty where you are driving over that bridge and it cuts in on the scene where you shoot Makarov in the head.
There you go.
And you just run over them.
Alright, I'm gonna jump. I'm gonna do it, man. Yeah, I missed the points, but I found the secret. And at last, at the end, I find one of the things that I really wanted to show off in this game.
The snow.
No, the secrets in the, like, spotting that and what seems to be a frozen waterfall that you can't go through, but hey, you can. It's a secret. A big old shortcut.
Yet you're still in third.
Yeah, it didn't really work out as well as I would hope.
Woohoo!
I can still make it. This is a really long race, though.
Yeah, the tracks in this are extremely long.
Very large. But that's, you know, benefit of the cartridge, is they can be streaming the data off the cartridge and not have to worry about...
Also, the best way to keep people playing is to just make a game have ridiculously long
forever.
Tracks.
Use initials, why not? Are you drowsy?
Yes.
I will save my game data, thank you. Alright, no rumble packs. Cleat, yes. So it's gonna give me, well, no, nothing. Okay. I guess you have to do championship to unlock things, whatever. Anyhow. So there you go. Beetle Adventure Racing.
I would suggest playing it with more people.
Yes. Beetle Battle at the very least is
yes.
not a good two-player game. Though I did, you know, I feel so careless that I didn't go in and try and unlock things ahead of time and check and see if I had my save. But the tracks get crazier, there are bigger jumps, there are all kinds of weird secrets, and one of the later stages, one of the secrets will take you into an underground cave, and you'll see a UFO in there for some reason. It's just, you know, strange things happen. You do crazy jumps, you get faster cars. Obviously, we only saw the very early game content, which is not usually the most exciting. So, I feel it's still a decent racing game.
Yeah.
I mean, we started...
It had good mechanics.
So, I like the really huge stages and all the alternate paths. I thought it was a great moment when I thought, oh, hey, I can jump here, and jumped off the track and drove through the frozen waterfall.
Yes.
So, think about that. There's more of that in later tracks.
More frozen waterfalls.
Well, not to say frozen waterfall, but, you know.
Barn doors.
Like barn doors, yes. Make sure you keep the barn door closed.
Yes.
Oh, Alex liked it when I crashed off the bridge. Okay. Well, then you must have enjoyed the fact that I did it twice.
Yeah.
And now I'm probably going to have to leave that in so this comment makes sense. I'm going to cut that out. Nobody needs to see that twice. Come on. All right, so yeah, fun game. Good N64 racer. They don't do a lot of wacky racers like that anymore.
They don't make them like they used to.
No, I feel like it's gotten to a point where you either have super realistic Forza or Gran Turismo competitor.
Or Mario Kart.
Yeah, and there's no more space in between. And this occupied space in between that's kind of been abandoned. So
like
I think it's still
Jack
worth going
X back to. Combat racing.
Yeah, that you know that kind of
bridge
also
the gap.
A similar, not the same place, but you know, along the continuum.
Well, had the items that you could shoot at each other and everything, but sort of had that more realistic look to it, but also was kind of cartoony at the same time.
Yeah, so I think like Jack is more toward the Mario Kart because you got all the weapons inside.
Yeah,
and Beetle Adventure Racing is more toward the realistic things because the weapons are only in an extra mode.
Yeah,
and most of the time you're just racing.
It's not combat racing.
No. Sometimes it looks like I missed Burnout, too. Yeah. But what you going to do?
Didn't know Burnout ended. I don't play racing games.
Yeah, it's been a while since I come out with one, but, which I will say, and I'll be editing this episode. And
FPS, RPG.
Yeah, they'll announce a new Burnout while I'm editing the episode. I'm like...
Revenge out. Or it'll be like, Burnout, Revenge of the Cool. And be like, what?
There you go.
Be a Donkey Kong crossover or something? I don't know.
Who knows? Could be all kinds of crazy. Oh, yeah. Fun game.
Yeah.
Kind of forgotten. Not deservedly, in my opinion. It deserves to be remembered and played again. But unfortunately, since it's a licensed game, it'll probably never be on virtual console or whatever sort of download service. So you will have to track down an N64 and a copy of the game if you want to be legal. And
yes.
I bet you do. You do. I'm telling you, you do. Yeah.
These aren't the ROMs you're looking for.
It's late in the day and we're getting weird. So I think this is a good time to end. I've been Dan Mastriani. You can find me at New Type Cola on Twitter.
At Ian G. Butterfield on Twitter. Ian Butterfield in real life, kind of.
Good, good. Hey, leave us a comment if you want to talk to us and suggest a game. Give us a like if you enjoyed this episode. Subscribe if you want to make sure you don't miss our next episode, when we'll see you next time on Retro Game Connect.